Welcome to the third video in a series designed to provide guidance in the process of setting up and running a sediment transport model with SRH2D. In this video, we will discuss parameters specific to sediment transport modeling. Topics will include shear partitioning, size class fractions and specific gravity, the different sediment transport equations, relevant parameters, and how a user may select an appropriate equation for specific modeling scenarios, and additional parameters that are independent of the selected equation. Once the model simulation is created, sediment modeling requires a number of additional parameters beyond those necessary for a hydraulic model run. To enable the sediment modeling capabilities of SRH2D, open the model control window, select the sediment tab, and check the Enable Sediment checkbox. This will reveal the fields that are needed to define the sediment properties and structure of the model. At the top of the window, the user specifies the shear partitioning option, which prescribes how much of the total shear stress in the water column is applied to the transport of sediment particles. SRH provides two options for partitioning the shear. For coarse bed systems, where the median grain size is greater than 2 millimeters, the scaled D90 approach is recommended. This approach bases the equivalent roughness height on the scaled factor of the grain size that is larger than 90% of the bed material. Lab experiments suggest the scaling factor can vary between 1.5 and 3. In the absence of more insight into the particular system being modeled, a value of 2.5 is appropriate. For fine-grained bed systems, the second shear partitioning option, percentage, is recommended. With this option, the user prescribes a direct percentage of the total shear to be applied to sediment transport. Previous versions of SRH2D used a value of 100%. Current recommended values range from 70 to 100%. This model example is a fine-grained system, and so the percent shear partitioning option is selected, and 100% of the shear will be applied. Below shear partitioning, the user has the option to specify a sediment simulation start time. If selected, the value entered is the number of hours the model will run in hydraulics-only mode before starting sediment calculations. This provides the user with the option of starting a sediment model dry and running towards a hydraulically steady condition, instead of requiring a restart file from a previous model run. For this example, we will allow for 5 hours of hydraulic modeling before beginning the sediment calculations. Sediment-specific gravity sets the solid density of the sediment as a factor of the density of water. A value of 2.65 is typical. The user then specifies the particle size class breakpoints to be used in the sediment calculations. Entering in increasing size, the single column list identifies the upper and lower bound of each class. When reviewing results after a model has executed, size class 1 is bound by rows 1 and 2, class 2 by rows 2 and 3, class 3 by rows 3 and 4, and so on. In this way, the total number of classes is equal to the number of rows minus 1. It is not recommended to use more than 7 size classes or 8 rows because of the increased computing time, though some situations may warrant more. Next on the window, the user selects the sediment transport equation. Within SMS, the modeler has 7 transport equations available and a last option to combine 2 equations. Each equation has a particular range of bed material for which it is best suited, and there is great overlap between the equations. Some equations use parameters that the user can adjust based on observed data or knowledge of the system modeled. In the absence of experience or additional information, using the default values is recommended. For sand bed channels, where the median grain size of the bed material is less than 2 millimeters, Englund Hansen is a popular choice, in addition to either Yang equation. For coarse grain channels with little to no sand, Meyer-Peter Mueller, commonly called MPM, and Parker work well. SRH2D implements the Wong and Parker modified version of the MPM equation and has further included a hiding factor, which is not part of the original formulation. A hiding factor attempts to adjust the shear stress applied to a particular grain size to account for the fact that small particles are more difficult to mobilize when surrounded by large particles, and large particles move more easily when surrounded by small particles. The MPM default hiding factor is 0, and can be raised up to 0.9 if the modeler decides it is warranted. The Parker equation was developed with a hiding factor and provides the modeler with the opportunity to adjust it from the default of 0.65. Additionally, the user can adjust the reference shields parameter. The shields parameter is a function of the particle size and hydraulic conditions, and is defined as the ratio of the shear stress applied to and the submerged weight of the particle. Another way to consider it is the ratio of the driving force trying to move the particle and the resistive force keeping the particle in place. Field and lab measurements suggest that when the driving force is between about 3 and 8% of the resistive force, measurable transport of the bed material will begin. There is not one single constant value because site-specific conditions such as channel slope, sediment shape, and gradation profile play a role in the initial mobilization of the bed material. Parker's equation allows the user to prescribe this threshold, and recommended values range between 0.03 and 0.08, with the default value of 0.04. Wilcock Crow and Wu are formulated to work well in coarse grain systems that have a significant amount of sand. Selecting the Wilcock-Crow equation provides the user with the opportunity to adjust two coefficients internal to the equation and specify the grain size that defines the threshold between sand and gravel. The default T1 and T2 coefficients of 0.021 and 0.036 should be used unless the user has additional insight into the behavior of the modeled system. Using a sand diameter of 1 millimeter is recommended as well. Selecting the Wu equation provides the user the ability to adjust the critical shields parameter. In this case, the default value is 0.03. With the mixed option, SRH2D provides the user with the ability to use one relationship for smaller sediment classes and a different relationship for larger classes. The modeler specifies the size class number to represent the cutoff between the higher and lower size classes. In theory, this provides the user with additional flexibility to construct a model. However, there have been no studies indicating the validity of this approach, and the modeler is encouraged to exercise caution when using this approach. It is important to keep in mind that there is generally no objectively best equation to select for any given model application. It is not uncommon to use several different equations and compare the results. Further reading on the background and development of each equation and repeated experience will help instill confidence in the final selection. For more detailed information on the development of these equations, the viewer is referred to the SRH2D User's Manual or FHWA's HEC 16 Reference Manual. Several additional parameters that are independent of the transport equation are needed to complete a sediment model setup. Water temperature affects the fall velocity of suspended sediment, though non-cohesive sediment transport is not particularly sensitive to this parameter. SMS includes the default value of 25 degrees Celsius, which is about 77 degrees Fahrenheit. Cohesive sediment modeling is more dependent on this value, and the modeler may provide a better estimate of the modeled conditions if known. The adaptation coefficients for suspended load determine the rate at which the water column achieves an equilibrium suspended sediment concentration as it transitions between areas of different shear stress. The dimensionless coefficients of 0.25 for deposition and 1.0 for erosion are provided by default, and there is generally no reason to change them. The adaptation length for bed load transport provides a similar purpose in determining how long it takes to achieve the full transport capacity of the bed load. SRH2D provides 5 options for establishing this length, with the first two being the most commonly used. In gravel bed rivers, where the D50 is greater than 2 millimeters, the approach of specifying a constant length between 1 and 5 channel widths is recommended. The Phillips-Sutherland saltation length formula automatically calculates a length based on the median grain size and local hydraulics, and is the recommended approach for sand bed rivers. The remaining selections on the list are from earlier versions of SRH2D and are not recommended for use. The active layer refers to the part of the channel bed that is actively engaged in the mixing between sediment moving as bed and suspended load and the particles at rest. The active layer prescribes to the model how much sediment is available for entrainment into the water column at each computational time step. It is recommended to select the thickness based on D90 option and use a factor between 1 and 3 for gravel rivers and 5 to 14 for sandbed rivers. Alternatively, the layer thickness can be expressed as a constant if the user wishes to prescribe it directly. At the bottom of the model control window is a checkbox for enabling cohesive sediment modeling. Most modeling applications are not significantly influenced by cohesive sediment, so this topic will be covered in a separate video. With all of the methods selected and parameters assigned, click OK to close the model control window. This concludes the third video in the series designed to provide guidance in the process of setting up a sediment transport model with SRH2D. In this video, we discussed modeling parameters specific to the sediment transport modeling, including shear partitioning, size class fractions and specific gravity, those associated with the different sediment transport equations, and how a user may select an appropriate equation for their application, and required parameters that are independent of the selected equation. In the next video, we will discuss executing and evaluating a sediment transport model. For more information on additional videos, documents, and other reference material about two-dimensional modeling in SMS, please navigate to the link provided here.